إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله، بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة وتركنا على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك، فصلوات الله وسلامه عليه وعلى من استنى بسنته واقتفى أثره إلى يوم الدين. أيها الأحبة في الله، أفضل الذكر لا إله إلا الله، وأفضل الدعاء الحمد لله، وأفضل عمل اتباع سنة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. احمل هما واحدا هو كيف ترضي الله سبحانه وتعالى. لذا فاعرف نفسك وكل للناس حسنى. Brothers and sisters, the best of dhikr is to say لا إله إلا الله. And the best of dua is to say Alhamdulillah. And the best of action is to follow the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In order for you to live a life that pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which should be a goal for every one of us, you have to know yourself. And if you know yourself, you will know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you have to say good to people. يعني talk good. Treat people good. Deal with people good. Islam is not a religion of relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only. Islam is a relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and with people. You have to satisfy both to call yourself a good Muslim. And that's why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he guided us for our daughters or sisters, time of marriage, when someone comes to ask their hand, he conditioned the quality of the person by saying tardawna dinahu wa khuluqah. If a person comes and you're happy with his deen, yani you're happy with his relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's someone who prays five times a day, pays the zakah, and does the basic things with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then he did not stop there. He said, وَخُلُقَهُ, and his manners. Automatically, a person, when he is good with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and does the worships right, automatically he will have good manners. Where is the catch here? We worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but we don't know how. We worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but we don't live it. We don't act upon it. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, you may pray, and your prayer is barely, part of it is accepted, and some is all rejected. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, salah prevents you from evil actions and talking. And how come it's not doing that? It's because we're not doing it right. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam want us to make sure that the person is good in his religion and he's acting upon it right, so his manners are good with people. How many days your life? Three. Yesterday, today, and tomorrow. Yesterday is gone. Today is about to be gone, and tomorrow you have no idea if you're going to make it. And that is why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam always guides us to remember death. And that is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He said, اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم وأتممت عليكم نعمتي ورضيت لكم الإسلام دينا. What does that ayah means? Today I have perfected your religion and completed my favors upon you and accepted Islam for you as a way of life or as a deen. What does that mean? It means what is legislated as haram is haram, even if everybody is doing it. So don't come and tell me riba is no longer riba because everybody deals with it. It's still a war with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, regardless. It means that hijab will continue to be hijab, even if all women don't wear it. Just because the majority of women don't wear hijab doesn't mean it's an obligation by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And death is coming even if no one talks about it or remembers it. Just because we don't talk about death or people fear to talk about death or people avoid talking about death or people hate talking about death, that doesn't mean death is not coming. That is the meaning of الْيَوْمَ أَكْمَلْتُ لَكُمْ دِينَكُمْ الْيَوْمَ أَكْمَلْتُ لَكُمْ دِينَكُمْ وَأَتْمَمْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعْمَتِي. This is how we should understand from this ayah a little bit further than the apparent meaning of the ayah. Two people, one was selling vinegar and another was selling honey, shops next to each other. People are all over that place who sells vinegar. Businesses, mashallah. The one who's selling honey, hardly any customers coming, and when they come, they don't return. So he figured, maybe my price is because it's honey is expensive. They go there. So he start lowering the price and lowering the price until he made the price of the honey equals to the price of vinegar. It did not change anything. So he went to the guy who sells vinegar and he told him, what's the deal? Vinegar tastes horrible and smells bad. Honey tastes good and smells good. Yet people coming over your shop and they're not coming to my shop. The answer from his neighbor came. He told him, because I sell my vinegar with a honey tongue. You sell your honey with a vinegar tongue. Did you get that? Did you? No? You know what that means? Speech. It's how you talk to people. It's how you address people. It's how you welcome people. A lot of people turn you away from the first sentence. And some people, before you even speak, they already like you. وَقُولُوا لِلنَّاسِ حُسْنًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قُولُوا لِلنَّاسِ. Talk to people, not Muslims. People. Muslims are not Muslims. That is a quality that you cannot find but in Islam. Where manners are acted upon at all times with whoever. Other religions, it's for benefits. I can make some good business, I'll talk to you and smile to you and do everything possible to earn your business. Beyond that, no manners. Muslim, no. I could be in pain and smiling in your face. Because smiling is a charity. I'm not doing it but to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why I said in the beginning, your objective should be doing what pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the person who smiles a lot is optimistic, not only for the hasanat, but it will lead you to be happy and to make people happy. And that's pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, kana mubtasiban. He smiles. He only gets angry when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's rules are violated, which is something we need to work on. We see the haram left and right, and we could be laughing. Someone might tell you a joke, and it is really kufr. It's not just bad, kufr, and you think it's funny. And it could be funny, but funny to whom? To a person who doesn't know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I guarantee you that if the same joke is said about your mom or your dad, you'll probably kill the person. But to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's okay. And you call yourself, and I call myself when we do that, I'm a believer. And if I ask you or you ask me, do you love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Yes, I do. No, you don't. You don't even get close to loving Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with this manner and with this enjoining or defense about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us something when you die at time of death. One thing that every bad person wishes, يَقُولُ يَا لَيْتَنِي قَدَّمْتُ لِحَيَاتِ. I wish I have done something good for my life. What life is he talking about? He's dying. Ah, you mean to tell me this is not a life? No, it's not a life. That's why some people, when you are not doing good, what does he tell you? Go get a life. For a religious person, it means do something good. For another person, you're not really living good. Why? Because his life is this life, not the hereafter. He probably doesn't even believe in the hereafter. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَإِنَّ الدَّارَ الْآخِرَةَ لَهِيَ الْحَيَوَانِ لَوْ كَانُوا يَعْلَمُونَ. The hereafter is a real life. So when I die, my real life starts. So when you celebrate your birthday, quote unquote, as if there is such a wonderful thing that you passed 1 year, you're closer to death 1 year, wow, let's throw a party. Alhamdulillah, I'm dying in 5 years, now it's four. Wow, I guess you throw a big party when there is 1 year left from your life. مَا لَكُمْ كَيْفَ تَحْكُمُونَ. So if you do that, in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, وَإِنَّ الدَّارَ الْآخِرَةَ لَهِيَ الْحَيَوَانِ, the real life is there. So you could be saying, for a good person, يعني a righteous person, let's say I'm dying in 5 years, how old am I? Minus five. Because it will get to zero. That's when I start the real life. That's when I'm born. After you die, you live. After you die and meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that's the life that we're working for. And that's why the person who dies say, I wish I have done something for my life. When? In his fake life, which is not the real life now that we are living in. This is a something that we should work for. When you talk about people who are negative in dealing with people in manners and talks and such, ask them a question. Look, even Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how He asked it. In Surah Al-Insan, He said, هَلْ أَتَى عَلَى الْإِنسَانِ حِينٌ مِنَ الدَّهْرِ لَمْ يَكُنْ شَيْئًا مَذْكُورًا. هَلْ أَتَى عَلَى الْإِنسَانِ. This is what we call سؤال تقريري. It is like an affirmative question. It's a question that is affirmed. يعني, has come a time where you were nothing? What's the answer? Yes. Before you're born one day, What was your name? Where were you? Who knows you? No one. So, if you were like this, you came from a time where you don't even exist. Now you're acting arrogant and you are dealing with people like you are it and they are nothing. Humble yourself down. That leads us to a story by Al-Asma'i. He is a storyteller, famous in telling relating stories and poets and such. In the second century, he was born. He passed by Al-Muhallab ibn Abi Sufra. Al-Muhallab ibn Abi Sufra, he was a governor on Khurasan at the time of Abd al-Malik ibn Marwan, the Umayyad Khalifa. Now, Al-Muhallab ibn Abi Sufra is a good person. But sometimes you can be a good person and you have a negative quality. Not sometimes, just about all the time. Everybody has some bad quality. The way he was walking, he passed by Malik ibn Dinar. Malik ibn Dinar is a real righteous person who just secluded himself from this dunya and focusing on the hereafter. And he's a man. And when I say he's a man, I'm referring to enjoining good and forbidding evil. If you don't enjoin good and forbid evil, you're not a man. Don't come and tell me how righteous you are when you don't make an impact on people, advising him for good and trying to prevent him from evil. And by the way, why do people don't enjoin good and forbid evil? Chicken? I'm not saying that you go with a rude way or a disrespectful way or without knowledge. I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about someone who knows how to do it. I'm talking about someone who has manners. I'm talking about someone who understands evil, small evil and bigger evil. I'm talking about a person who is not there to embarrass people. I'm talking a person who wants good for the other person. And when I come and enjoy good or forbid evil with you, what am I looking for? I'm looking for that you stop the evil and get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So definitely I'm going to do it the way the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam does it. And you never humiliate a person and you get him closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Malik ibn Dinar, he was from those people. A lot of people don't enjoy good because he's your buddy. You don't want to lose a friend or he's a relative. You know, this is my friend, my dad, my cousin, my mom. Habibi, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants you to do something, قُلْ إِنْ كَانَ آبَاؤُكُمْ وَأَبْنَاؤُكُمْ وَإِخْوَانُكُمْ وَأَزْوَاجُكُمْ وَعَشِيرَتُكُمْ وَأَمْوَالٌ اقْتَرَفْتُمُوهَا وَتِجَارَةٌ تَخْشَوْنَ كَسَادَهَا وَمَسَاكِنُ تَرْضَوْنَهَا أَحَبَّ إِلَيْكُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ وَجِهَادٍ فِي سَبِيلِهِ فَتَرَبَّصُوا. If you think your family and your kinship and your wealth and your homes and all of that is more beloved to you than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then wait. It's coming. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us when He mentioned all the sins of the evil people before and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed them, you know what He said at the end of the ayah? وَمَا ذَلِكَ مِنَ الظَّالِمِينَ بِبَعِيدٍ. And this is not far away from people who do the same thing. أَكُفَّارُكُمْ خَيْرٌ مِّنْ أُولَٰئِكُمْ أَمْ لَكُمْ بَرَاءَةٌ فِي الزُّبُرِ. You think your sins is different than the people's sin who got destroyed? It's no difference. They got destroyed, you could be next. And that is the scary part of those who reflect on the ayat. So anyway, Malik ibn Dinar told him, he was walking arrogantly, he told him, إِنَّهَا لَمِشْيَ يَكْرَهُهَا اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى إِلَّا فِي الْقِتَالِ. He's basically telling him a hadith. He said, the way you walk, the way you stand, is something Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala hates unless you are doing it against the enemy, arrogant on the enemy during war. يعني showing them power and strength. He's talking to whom? Malik ibn Dinar is just an average person. He's talking to a governor. He's talking to someone big. Look at the answer. قال أما تعرفني؟ He said, you don't know me? Actually, this is nice. You know, because a lot of people that give you the slap or you get the sentence before you even ask the question. And he was, as I said, he was good. He told him, maybe you don't know me. Look at Malik ibn Dinar, how he answered him. He could have told him, yeah, I know, you're a muhallab, you're the governor, your name is such and such. No. قال, yes. أعرفك حق المعرفة. I know you very well. أولك نطفة نادرة. You started from a despicable sperm. وآخرك جيفة قذرة. And you end up with a corpse that stinks. يعني when you die. وأنت فيما بين ذلك تحمل العذر. And between that, you're carrying your stool around. Any of us brothers different than that? Look at the answer. قال نعم إنك تعرفني حق المعرفة. He told him, indeed, you know me very well. The good person, when they sin and when they deviate and they're reminded, they accept the reminder and they take it. And that's exactly what he did. And that is why one of his quotes, look what he said, قال الحياة خير من الموت. Life is better than death. قال ولو أعطيت ما لم يعطه أحد لأحببت أن تكون لي أذن أسمع بها ما يقال في غدا إذا مت. He said, if I like something after I die, is that Allah grants me an ear that I hear what people are going to say about me after I die. When someone tells you this, you know what that means? He strives so hard to do good. He will be like Prophet Ibrahim عليه السلام when he made dua. وَجَعَلْ لِي لِسَانَ صِدْقٍ فِي الْآخِرِينَ. Oh Allah, give me a truthful tongue. Give me a good remembrance that people remember me tomorrow when I'm dead. Did his dua get accepted? Yes. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم. والله سبحانه وتعالى قال ملة أبيكم إبراهيم إن إبراهيم كان أمة ثم أوحينا إليك أن اتبع ملة إبراهيم حنيفة. سورة in the name of إبراهيم عليه السلام. Why? Because brothers and sisters, when you want good remembrance, you need to leave a trace behind you. You need to leave something that people remember you with good. Oh, Allah yarhamu, this is the person who donated the parking lot. This is the person who donated such and such for Palestine, or donated such and such for Sudan. By the way, brothers and sisters, how many of you know what's going on in Sudan? 13 million people in horrible situation, displaced, you name everything horrible. Not a person talking about them. I know people are so busy with what's going in Palestine, and I'm not blaming anything in Syria and other places. But Sudan is forgotten. Very little, very few people donate for Sudan. Brothers, give. Today, they want you, the boxes are there, give. Remember your Muslim brothers and sisters in Sudan. Remember that suffering is something, يعني, no one wishes for. No one wants. Imagine when a person leaves his home. Just picture yourself. Sometimes you have a flood at home. Sometimes you have a fire at home. What happens? MashaAllah, you have insurance. What does the insurance do? He pays for your hotel. You go to the hotel and you become, what a miserable life. All the family have to stay in hotel. Can you imagine? We have to stay for 3 days in 5-star hotel. Complaining, of course. It sounds like, no, we will be complaining. Imagine when you have no home, no food, no drink, nothing, and children, and also threatened in your life and your wife or your daughter to be raped. Yes. Muslims, yes. Imagine when you have no idea when you're going to go home. You have no idea if you have home or you will ever get home. So that's why, brothers and sisters, when you talk about manners, when you talk about dealing with people, reflect on that. Reflect on our brothers and sisters who are in need. In particular today, we're focusing on Sudan. Our brothers in Sudan are in bad need. When I say 13 million, it's actually everyone. But these are the worst situations. And hardly you hear about it. It seems like the whole world don't want to even talk about it. It's like, yeah. فخار كسر بعضه زي ما بقولها. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. My dear brothers and sisters, هل أتى على الإنسان حين من الدهر لم يكن شيئا مذكورا. We were nothing before the creation. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us and dignified us, He told us, be good with one another. وَقُولُوا لِلنَّاسِ حُسْنًا. Know how weak you are and know how badly you are in need for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So don't ever think that your money will get you salvation in this life or the hereafter, or your strength or your power or anything. It can go any minute. And those people who give and who do charity, كما يقول العلماء, إذا زادت الصدقة زاد الرزق. When charity is increased, your sustenance is increased. Guaranteed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Each hasana is tenfold, up to 700 and more. Those who believe in the Quran are the one who always give charity. It doesn't matter how much, if they gave it yesterday or today, it doesn't matter. If I tell you I have a deal for you, each dollar you invest with me, you get $10, and you believe me, and you saw it, and you did it. And then I tell you, $1, $10, would you give me $1 if I come and say, how about tomorrow? I come and say, give me $2, I'll give you $20. You say, no, I'm not going to give you that. You're not asking me for a dollar every day. You're not going to, you'll be laughing. Yes, I'll give you $1,000. I'm willing to borrow money so I can invest with you. How come we don't do that with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Can you give me anything less than faith is weak? No. I'm talking about people who have the money. And I'm talking about just about every one of us. I'm sure you can afford a dollar. I'm sure you can afford 50 cents. I'm sure you can afford walking by that box and ignore the person standing as if he's collecting for his parents or for himself. How can a Muslim pass in the masjid, in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, pass and ignore the boxes and whoever is taking? Brother, 50 cents, 1 cent, anything, just give something. فَمَا يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ ذَرَّةٍ خَيْرًا يَرَىٰ. If you do at an atom size, you know, proton, electron, and all that stuff, that size will make a difference in your scale the day of judgment. You want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to remember you and to know you and to give you? Remember other people, brothers. إحرس, I conclude. Listen to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as he said, إحرس على ما ينفعك. Be keen to do what benefits you. And this will, inshallah, benefit you. أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يجعلنا من الذين يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنه أولئك الذين هداهم الله وأولئك هم أولو الألباب. اللهم آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها مولاها. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم انصر إخواننا المستضعفين في كل مكان. اللهم انصر إخواننا في فلسطين. اللهم فرج عن إخواننا في السودان. اللهم كن معهم يا رب العالمين. اللهم أطعم جياعهم واكس عراهم واسقي عطاشهم واشف مرضاهم وتقبل شهداءهم وارحم موتاهم. اللهم كن معهم يا رب العالمين. كن مع إخواننا في سوريا، كن مع إخواننا في السودان وفي الصومال وفي جميع أنحاء العالم. يا رحمن يا رحيم ارحمنا، لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إنا كنا من الظالمين. وصل اللهم وسلم على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين، وأقم الصلاة.